Education Superintendent Jim Rex and State Senator Robert Ford. News 4 Stephanie Trotter traveled to Camden and spoke with Vincent Sheheen.
Good evening, downtown Camden, historic downtown Camden, celebrating tonight the winner of the Democratic nomination. Joining me now, Vincent Sheheen. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, and welcome to Camden.
Republicans have had a stronghold on the governor's office for almost two straight decades, really, other than Jim Hodges. What makes you different? How can you crack in there and actually win more than one term?
Well, the timing is different. People are frustrated with the lack of progress in South Carolina, our inability to move forward, and a lot of the distractions that we've seen over this last decade. And then I bring a message of building bridges together with people in South Carolina. I've got a reputation for helping folks come together to solve the problems that we have as I've served in the state Senate. And I am really a person who's grounded in community here in Camden, but also in the larger South Carolina. I'm excited about the opportunity to bring that statewide.
A lot has been made of Nikki Haley's personal life. Should she win the Republican nomination, will you explore that issue as well?
We plan on focusing on the substantive issues in this campaign and running the general election just as we have the primary, which is talk about how we can create jobs in South Carolina, how we can partner with small business to create development and prosperity for all of South Carolinians, and also getting back on public education and how we can move it forward instead of it always being under attack, as it seems so often to be right now. So we plan on focusing on those substantive issues that really matter and that unfortunately for the last decade or so have not been focused on.
Specifically, what can the upstate expect should you win?
Well, I am a Clemson University graduate, and my wife actually graduated from Walhalla High School. So our roots go very strongly into the upstate. I've been to Greenville and Spartanburg numerous times. I'm committed to job creation in the upstate and linking through the infrastructure that we need, our port down in Charleston, with the upstate development possibilities that we have, and also focusing on projects like ICAR and other great opportunities that we have.
Well, we look forward to seeing you much more in the coming months.
Thank
Congratulations.
You so
once
Thank you
again.
For being here. Thank you.
So there you have it. We'll talk more with him tonight. Stay tuned tomorrow morning for more on his plans and what we can expect in the coming months. Stephanie Trotter, WYFF News 4 in Camden.